Hello guys, welcome to today's video. In today's video, we'll be looking at psychology as a field of study. We'll be looking at psychology as a field one is interested in and what it takes to be a psychologist, what it takes to be called a psychologist, the route one has to take in order to be called a psychologist. Psychology as a field is a very long and testing journey. It requires love and patience. To be a psychologist is a very long route. I have a degree in psychology, I have honors in psychology, but I'm not a psychologist. Reason why is that to be a psychologist, you have to have master's degree with an institution that is accredited with PSTD. So you have to have master's degree. Reason why is I'm not a psychologist that a psychologist is that I ended at honors level. A very broad field. And at master's level, you are required to choose a specialty. You are required to choose a field that you are interested in and you like to specialize in. Like there is clinical psychology, there is counseling psychology, there is a psychometrist, there is a forensic psychology, there is a neuropsychologist, there is a registered counselor and educational psychology. So let's get into this video and address them one by one. Firstly, let's look at the one that does not require a master's degree. That is a registered counselor. A registered counselor helps clients get to their optimal functioning. They do intervention strategies to help clients to do their optimal best. To be a registered counselor, you must have a 4-year B-side degree with the institution accredited with HPCSA. The reason why I'm not a registered counselor, even though I have a honors degree, is that I did BA instead of B-side. I have a degree of Bachelor of Arts in Criminology and Psychology. To be a registered counselor, you must have a B-side degree, not BA. Universities offering this degree, this B-side degree, is University of Limpopo, University of Johannesburg, SACAP, Univen, University of Northwest, and Nelson Mandela University. Secondly, let's look at a psychometrist. What exactly is a psychometrist? A psychometrist is a person who has expertise in administering psychological tests. A psychometrist uses a psychological test to measure any mental deficits a person can have, such as learning disabilities and others. And also, a psychological test may be used at a place of employment for evaluation before they hire individual. To be a psychometrist, after completing your B-Psych degree, which is 4 years, or after completing your honors degree, you apply for a psychometric program, which is usually offered by UJ and Nelson Mandela University and also Northwest University. The program is usually 6 months. You apply for that 6 month program, and after that, you are qualified to be called a psychometrist. So now let's look at the most loved field of study, which is clinical psychology. Most people that apply for psychology usually want to be clinical psychologists. It is the most common one. It's a field of psychology that focuses on the diagnosis and treatment of mental disorders. The most common types of mental disorders to be diagnosed and treated include depression, schizophrenia, and also anxiety disorders. These are the most common disorders that are usually diagnosed and treated in individuals. A very, very competitive field of study. This is a very competitive field of psychology. Last time I checked, no university accept more than 10 students per year. Imagine, like, there are 100-something students that apply, but only 10 spaces in each university. So the competition is very, very high. You must be ready for competition. List of universities where clinical psychology is offered include University of Limpopo, Free State University, University of Northwest, Rhodes University, Stellenbosch University, UK's at N Sefako Makgato, particularly known as Medusa. There is UNISA, it is also offered there. There is UP, at least, like, there are many universities offering this program of clinical psychology. So let's look at counseling psychology. This a field of psychology that help individuals, that help clients deal with a day-to-day problems that they may encounter, just such as one having a problem choosing a career. They help with day-to-day problem. The difference between clinical psychology and counseling psychology is that clinical psychology deals with more severe problems than counseling psychology. A counseling psychologist cannot deal with a person that is, let's say, cutting themselves. That problem is more severe. It has to be dealt with by a clinical psychologist. Another field of psychology, which is the fifth one, I think, is educational psychology. It is a branch of psychology whereby the main concern is the educational system and educational setting of learners. It works in a way to help optimize human development in terms of learning. It usually involves working with children that have learning disabilities. Universities offering this program include Vets University, UP, UKZN, and Stellenbosch University. So UJ, not forgetting UJ. Okay, like on the sixth branch of psychology is educational or organizational psychology, is a branch of psychology that involves working in an environment whereby it involves making sure that employees are taken care of, basically. It applies psychological principles to human resource, to sales, to marketing, to make sure that employees are not strained at work, they are taken care of, they work under healthy environment. It involves a training of employees and employers, and also doing policy training to employers to make sure that their employees are taken care of, to make sure that their employees are better beings mentally, their work is not mentally straining them. Universities offering this program include UJ, UKZN, University of Zululand, Nelson Mandela University, Stellenbosch University, UNISA, and also University of Pretoria is offering this program in praying. Okay, let's look at the field that I'm mostly interested in, that is, it is neuropsychology. Neuropsychology is a field of psychology that focuses on the brain. It looks at different parts of the brain, how different of the part of the brain affect behavior. For example, if this part of the brain is damaged, it can lead to a person having this kind of behavior. I've looked at universities. I don't know which university offer this kind of program in South Africa. I've looked. I couldn't find the universities offering this program in South Africa. If you know any university offering this program, please comment down below. The last field of psychology that we are going to tackle is forensic psychology. This is a field of psychology that focuses on applying psychology to criminal investigation and law. We are done with different fields of psychology. So let's look at what it takes to get to master's level. You must have 60% overall at honors level, or final BSEC degree, you must have 60%. I would advise you to work hard if you want to be a psychologist in South Africa. The competition is very high. I remember when I applied for my honors level, there were about 144 applicants, but they only took 16 of us. So the competition is very high. So work hard if you want to be a psychologist, if it is really your field of interest. Yeah, that is the end of our video. Please comment down below which field of psychology are you mostly interested in, or would you like to pursue? Bye.